In the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. My text for the Sunday is taken from the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 10, verse 20. Rejoice that your names are written in heaven. Just 20 days from now, 20 short days, and Cindy will be joining with Joe and April Way and with 8 of our Journey to Adulthood teens and 3 teens from St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Colombia on an 8-day pilgrimage to Peru. It's going to be fantastic. And the ultimate destination of our trip is Machu Picchu, the lost, hidden city of the Incas, high in the Andes Mountains. And as exotic as that is, our purpose is even larger. For our purpose is not to attend a particular destination. Our larger purpose is to experience the culture of other people, encounter and understand and appreciate them, learn about their faith story, and create our own faith story with them. Because that is the purpose of pilgrimage. And in preparation for this pilgrimage, Joe and April and all the Journey adult teams, and with your help, have done a great job of getting prepared. Starting with the fundraising, just a couple weeks ago, we had the Blueberry Festival here. Delicious blueberry treats. We had Blue Sky Fall Band playing out in the courtyard in the night. It was just beautiful, fantastic. We had the Christmas resale. We had scrapbooking, Mary Ellen. Did we do the scrapbooking? That was an event for the Journey to Adulthood pilgrimage. We had April's chocolate and peanut butter Easter eggs. Whew, what does that break, Lent? And of course, the ever popular St. John's pretzel sandwich sale after church on Sunday, including the real meal deal here at St. John's. Boy, it's just that good. And thank you to all of you who helped make this pilgrimage possible by your support, because you've enabled our teens really to take ownership and responsibility for this amazing experience that they're about to share. But that's not the only preparation. There's been medical preparation. MMR, measles, mumps, rubella, DPT, I don't know what that is. Typhoid fever, don't want to find out what that is. Tetanus shots, hepatitis A. I should be about bulletproof to every known bug on the planet. That's been a thrill. But most importantly is the preparation that comes in the packing. Let me share with you just some of the highlights from our packing list. Everyone needs to bring a towel, okay? Everyone needs to bring a refillable water container, okay? Closed-toe shoes are an absolute must. Sunscreen, bug repellent, a rain jacket is a must. We don't stop just because it's raining. Since we will be encountering all types of people, please remind the students that cultural sensitivity is important with regard to dress. So I guess that means no Justin Bieber t-shirts. What I find striking is how remarkably similar these preparations and that packing list is to our reading from the Gospel of Luke this morning. As Luke prepares to send out his 70 disciples to those towns and villages that Jesus plans to visit, he gives with them their marching orders, their packing list. He begins by saying to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray, therefore, to the Lord of the harvest to send laborers out into the harvest. Jesus begins with prayer. Prayer doesn't come at the end. Prayer is the first thing Jesus calls us to. And typically, we kind of save prayer for those panic moments in our lives. When we find ourselves in difficulty or stress, that is when we normally reach out to God. And that's natural, that's good, that's wonderful. But Jesus encourages us to put prayer first, to put prayer forward, to allow prayer not to be some rescue operation, but allow prayer to be a positive experience in our daily life and faith. And when we pray, Jesus suggests that we not pray for success or accomplishment. Jesus tells the disciples, pray that the Lord of the harvest will send out laborers into the harvest. The first prayer is to invite others in. It's not to make the mission a success. What defines the success of the mission is the people who become involved in it. It's not a task to accomplish, it is a community to create. Then Jesus says, I'm sending you out like lambs in the midst of wolves. That's a little frightening in my mind to think of our journey to adulthood, lambs being sent out in the midst of wolves. What I think Jesus is referencing here is a passage from the prophet Isaiah. And the prophet Isaiah looked forward to that future, that kingdom of God, where the lion eats straw like the ox, and the lamb and the wolf will dwell together. That perfect, peaceable kingdom. And this is what Jesus is sending his disciples out to help create and to build and to establish, that peaceable kingdom of God. He also advises, travel light. As we will be traveling light, the rule is if you have to think about packing it, don't pack it. And the same kind of rule applies to all the disciples. Because what Jesus is saying to the disciples is not that you need to be equipped. He suggests that you need to be de-equipped. You need to take stuff out of your life and rely on what is important. And that's each other and God. That quality of relationship is what defines the strength and the resources in your mission and in your ministry. And as you meet others, greet them in peace. Not just shalom, the common, ordinary courtesy greeting, but the shalom of one sharing in peace. That is to say, we as Christians are called into a quality of relationship with others. Not just any kind of relationship. We are open to all sorts of people, but we do have standards and values that define who we are in relationship with others. And one of those core values is the value of peace. A value of peace, which we are called to share with each other. Now, that doesn't mean we have to think all alike. That doesn't mean we have to agree about everything. We are a diverse community. We're entitled to different perspectives and opinions. But what is required is that we have like values. That we have shared values. And we can discuss about how we live into those values, but we begin with a standard of shared values, the core value being peace. And then, if you face rejection, Jesus says, it's not about you. You don't need to personalize other people's rejection. I'll tell you what to do. Shake it off, literally. Take off the shoes of your feet and just shake it off and move on. Because it's not about you. It's about sharing in the creation of the kingdom of God. So with these marching orders, this packing list, Jesus sends the disciples out. And they finally return and they say, Lord, it was unbelievable. All the things that happened, it was an incredible faith experience. And Jesus responds, yep, told you so. In fact, this is how we defeat Satan. This is how we fight with evil. We defeat Satan and fight with evil not by domination, but by invitation. Not by conquering, but encountering. This is the quality of mission that we are called to. The mission that was established in the very beginning with these 70 disciples that Jesus sends forth. The same way we are going to be sending forth our journey to adulthood pilgrims to Peru. It is grounded in the gospel of God. It is focused on a gospel of peace. It is about pulling us together, not to accomplish any particular great task, but to live together in great relationship. Not to accomplish any particular thing other than to build us up individually and as the body of Christ. That is the mark of our accomplishment. That is what we invite people to share it. That we, with them, might live into that prayer where we have our names with theirs written in heaven. Amen.